So congrats, Mark. You're the inaugural BYB lightweight champion. How does that feel right now?
It's the greatest feeling in the world. Like a friend of mine once said, if I could bottle this feeling and sell it, I'd be a billionaire.
Was it of a challenge to come out to these people cheering him on and actually booing you?
Yeah, you know, I expected that. You know, I knew I was the bad guy in this situation, so I was ready for that. But energy is energy, whether it's positive or negative. I take it and I feed off it, and that's what I did. I took that negative energy and I used it as fuel for my fire.
So you had to overcome a lot of adversity, right? First the crowd, then you were down. How did you mentally deal with all this, and what made you come back in this fight and actually win it?
Yeah, you know, I'm a savage. I'm a dog through and through. I got that dog in me. A lot of people thought I was just a pretty boy with a pretty face. But, you know, I got the will to win. I have the heart of a champion. I will never stop. You know, I'm not going to lie. He hurt me early in that fight, but I never doubted myself. I never stopped believing in myself, and I never stopped coming. And that's why I am the champion of the world in the most savage sport on earth, which makes me the baddest man on the motherfucking planet.
I was reading that you actually got hooked on bare knuckle because you saw somebody fighting on YouTube, right? Tell us about that.
Yeah, you know, I was boxing professionally in Mexico during the pandemic, and I wasn't making any money, and nobody was watching, and nobody cared. And one day I was sitting there watching YouTube, and a bare knuckle fight popped up, and I was like, wow, this is crazy. And then another one popped up, and then another one, and I probably watched about half a dozen bare knuckle fights. And then I thought to myself, you know what, Mark? You can beat most of these guys.
Do you think that is your sport? What makes you so dangerous in there?
You know, I'm a savage. I'm a monster. You know what I mean? Gloves, no gloves, you know, in a ring, a triangle, a cage, on the street, it don't matter. In a fight, you know, I'm a dog. You don't want to be in a fight with me.
Some people even say that it might hurt you more if you hit somebody than you getting hit.
Yeah, you know, my opponent actually broke his hand on my face. You know, I got a hard head. I'm made out of steel. And, you know, if you're not ready for that, if you're not careful, well, that's what happens.
How much did your face, you probably got stitched up as well. How much was it bothering you? You probably had no vision anymore.
I had no vision in my left eye after the knockdown. I was completely blind in that eye. So it was difficult for sure, but you know, if you took vision in both my eyes, I was going to keep coming until I couldn't come anymore.
Now you're at the pinnacle of the sport, right? Is there anyone you want to call out? Where do you want to go next?
Doesn't matter to me. My next fight's going to be for the Police Gazette World Diamond Belt, whoever the Hall of Fame decides that's going to be against. Otherwise, you know, I'm open to putting the gloves back on, getting the ring of Floyd Money Mayweather, maybe beat up some old UFC fighters on Jake Paul's undercard. And lastly, I want to call out Joe Rogan. Joe Rogan, me and Uncle Creepy Ian McCall are coming on your podcast. And we're going to talk about the history of combat sports, past, present, and future, and bare knuckle boxing's history there within. And we'll have the full Joe Rogan experience. We will drink Buffalo Trace bourbon, smoke weed, eat elk steaks and psychedelic mushrooms. And if we have time afterwards, we'll talk about aliens.
Any family, friends, sponsors you want to thank?
Yeah, absolutely. I want to thank my team, Bobby's Boxing Club, Laguna Beach, California, my head coach, Bobby Chavez, as well as my head coach, Ian Uncle Creepy McCall, A1 Boxing, Huntington Beach. I want to thank all my sponsors, CBD Health Solutions, Massage Matters, I don't even know, Accounting Your Life, A1 Boxing, Soul Physio, you know, there's two, Evolution Fitness. There's too many to name. I love all you guys. I'll see you with the belt when I get back. I'm Mark the Shark Irwin with Bare Knuckle News, and no one beats us to the punch. Boom!